you give me 1, 2, and 3, then I'm good. All right. Welcome. I'm glad to see everybody here tonight for our musical play with music. I don't know what you call it. It doesn't have a lot of music, but anyway, I have a couple of reminders. Number one, if you think, silence your phones. I don't care if you take pictures, but if you can avoid flashes, that would be great, although it'll be fine. Anyway. In the parlor when you came through, right before you came through the last door, there was a place to sign your name up. We have a fun little prize basket that kind of goes with the show with some authorized and unauthorized swag, church swag in it. So if you didn't put your name in the basket, we won't collect the basket until the end of intermission, so you can do that at intermission. That being said, we will have a 10-minute intermission approximately in the middle of the show. Technically, it's more like 3/5 through the show. But I have to make a disclaimer because I didn't get it put in the program, but any lines and representation that might be in the show of any of our staff in-house were not approved or run by them. They had no input, and they don't know what's coming. It's very little. It's fine. But if you don't like something, it's on me, not them. So just so you know. Speaking of that, I want to say a huge thanks. I know, like, churches have a lot of politics sometimes and things, and it's not that I'm saying we don't have any of that, but, man, we have an amazing staff here, and they will all go to bat and come together and have your back and help. They all help each other do things. And it's a really wonderful environment to work in. And so I just want to thank our staff. And Pastor Tim, especially, has just like he's listed in there as Master of Tech. And man, he's totally come through helping me get all the sound and stuff figured out to the best of what we can do with our current sound equipment. So I just want to thank all of them very much for all of their help in the process of putting the show together. And that being said, enjoy the show.
One, take your seats. We need to get this meeting started so I can make my son's 4 o'clock soccer game. Okay. As this is our third meeting, we'll be making the final decisions about how to move forward with our mission for reaching the lost in our community. We've had a lot of creative ideas, especially from our younger task force members, although I don't think we'll be going with kick me if you want to know Jesus signs on our backs. Or creating an Among Us mod where we are the disciples finding the lost. We do, however, need to reach a decision. Thoughts?
I just don't see a better way to reach the lost than a Super Bowl commercial.
Super Bowl? Do we really want to be associated with that event? It's kind of become a trash fest.
Yeah, and why the Super Bowl? Isn't it Christmas time?
It's the football game of the year. It's probably the most viewed sporting event in our country, which also makes it incredibly expensive to have a Super Bowl commercial. Lisa, do you have an idea for how to pay for your Super Bowl commercial?
You didn't ask for ideas about paying for it. You only ask ideas. What about Hallmark? It is Christmas time, you know?
Well, paying for things is a reality as well. We could probably manage James' kick-me signs, but probably not a Super Bowl commercial.
How about a concert with a big-name artist that tells everyone that they need Jesus?
It's looking better for James' kick-me signs.
What if we created a new social media platform? We could call it Save-A-Gram, a message of Jesus, and a social media site, all wrapped in one.
What about the more traditional forms of social media, like MySpace or Facebook?
Nobody uses Facebook anymore. Well, nobody under 40, that is.
There are plenty of lost people over 40. Why not just go the traditional route? Let's publish a newspaper.
It all started right here, folks, the rebirth of newspaper. By the next year, everyone will be reading the newspaper again, and by the following, many will be new followers of Christ.
All right, James. Lots of people still read the newspaper, and I bet lots of businesses would be willing to put one out for us. It's not a horrible idea.
Can we deliver them with a song? Nothing touches people's hearts like music. Well, except Jesus. Seems like a perfect fit.
Okay, how about this? Let's each head up our own media project to reach the lost and spread the good news. We have lots of options and lots of ideas. All we need are the volunteers to make it happen.
Oh, great. Recruiting volunteers in this day and age?
We can do it. I'm sure I can try to get some of my friends to use TikTok for something good.
And I'll take the older crowd. Facebook, here I come.
So the newspaper's a go? This will be great fun.
And I guess Save-A-Gram could just be a real series on Instagram. It wouldn't have to be its own social media website. You know, don't reinvent the wheel and all that.
No, I've got a great idea for a commercial. We can do it locally. You guys are gonna love it.
Well, somebody has to do something with music, so I guess that's going to be me. Wait till you guys see what my group will have up their sleeves.
And my group will catch it all on video.
Okay, we've got a plan. Now we've just got to decide how we're going to track. How we're going to recruit all of those volunteers.
How about if we put all of our ideas together and have an outreach fair? How about September 17th after service?
Yeah, okay.
Oh wow, there's a lot of people here. Well, welcome to our outreach fair. The Reaching the Lost Task Force is looking for volunteers who are interested in using different forms of media to help spread the good news about Jesus. You then, is there a particular form of media you would be interested in using?
I mainly just practice.
You know, there are plenty of ways you could reach the lost with a newspaper. Can I sign you up?
No one wants to make a stuffy old newspaper. Don't you know that paper kills trees?
Newspaper? I love newspapers. Extra, extra, read all about it. Maggie, do you want to join the newspaper with me?
Sure, we love newspapers. The smell, the tradition, the typeset words. Do you have a printing press?
No. We'll probably just be printing on a good old-fashioned photocopier. But it'll still be great fun.
YouTube vlog. Ever want to be a famous YouTuber? Now's your chance.
Oh, we'll never get any volunteers with the kids hollering on at this rate.
Oh, don't worry, Lori. Everybody's gonna love your Instagram Save-A-Gram idea.
Well, at least it's better than a Hallmark commercial.
Songs, mainly on the subject of love. My idea for this group that we'll choose some songs, maybe write a few, and we'll do some gigs and flash mobs around town. I have a friend who works at the Olive Tree Cafe who'll help us plan a gig or book a spot. Cool, huh?
So it requires singing?
Yeah!
Oh, we'll pass. Thanks.
Send your friend.
Wow, what a turnout.
Can you believe this guy?
Yeah, usually you can't get people to volunteer for anything.
Yeah, it's so nice to see so many people who have such a heart for the Lord. How many signups have you got?
Oh, I have a few.
Just can't believe this turnout.
Somebody should be keeping count. We could call Pastor John and let him know his 8 weeks of announcements during the service really helped to put this event over the top.
Repetition, that's what I always say. If you want the people to remember it, you must repeat it.
Okay, so our first full real series on TikTok will be about the perspective of animals in Bethlehem. How crazy it must have been to be there at the birth of the Savior and not know a thing about it.
That's a great idea, Naomi.
Are you taking any suggestions?
I always encourage teamwork.
Teamwork makes the dream work. It's just like being in a choir. You there, have you ever wanted to join a choir?
Who, me?
Sure, you.
Don't let her fool you. I've seen her, and I've heard her sing around church.
I guess I do have some talent.
There's always room for more.
Where's the pen?
Little sister Gwen. Hi, Gwen. We're mighty glad you're here. being wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And then the shepherds go and seek the baby Jesus. And you are going to get to help tell that story. Isn't that exciting? Okay, we just need to decide what lines you're going to do, okay?
A baby Jesus sure had a funny bed.
Our first story should be big, catchy, something that'll make you notice and want to pick up and read our newspaper.
Does that mean we can use colored ink?
Ooh, color, I don't know. We'd have to get the color code to the copier. Maybe I could contact Pastor Tim and see if he would let us use the code just this one time.
Well, let's get started. Who is our editor-in-chief?
Oh, well, that would be me.
What about our copier?
Anyone?
I guess that could be me.
I could do layout.
Who will be sports editor?
Sports? Who ever thought about sports in a church newsletter?
People that go to church still like sports.
Yeah, I think sports is good. Okay, here we go. Why don't you two tackle sports?
See what I did there?
Tackle.
I guess you have a point there.
Well, let's get this moving. Go team!
Alright gang, we really want to see what we can get done with this mission, so let's start by making a mind map.
Oh fun, I love mind maps.
What's a mind map?
Do we need it? We'll get the hang of it, don't worry.
It's sort of a system of brainstorming. We'll use the subject branches to focus our ideas. It'll give us a visual to refer to as we move forward. It's simple to follow.
Okay, then let's go for it.
Okay, so we start by putting our main goal in the center, reaching the lost with the good news of Jesus. And now we branch out. So what are some things that come to mind when we think of the good news of Jesus?
Christmas?
No.
His
birth. Easter.
Grace.
Good. Any more?
Sacrifice.
All right. And now we branch out. So we'll start with Christmas. What ideas come to mind with Christmas?
Gifts.
Star.
Songs.
Kindness.
Oh, Miles, I love that. Acts of kindness. I mean, really, wasn't Christmas like the epic act of kindness? Kindness might not be quite the right word, but you get the idea.
Yeah, I love random acts of kindness.
Hey, maybe our first meal could be about this.
Oh, good idea. And great ideas and momentum. So let's move on to his birth.
Miracle.
Quiet.
Loud.
Hallelujah!
Wait, quietly and loud? I'm not sure that works.
Well, this is just brainstorming. It's all good. Plus, I think if you think about it, they both apply. So let's actually move to grace. Easter's great, but it's the Christmas season, so we're going to stick with Christmas. So, grace.
Hard to understand.
Forgiveness.
And safe.
For everyone.
Well, we're actually out of time now, guys, so this has been really good. Let's try and think of a three-part real series using these ideas to start. We can break up into three groups and then think of ideas from there.
Okay. Sounds good.
Lori, you and I can work on random acts of kindness.
Iris and I will work on the good news reel.
Yep.
I guess us guys will take the for everyone reel.
Correct.
All right. Well, we can just communicate as a group and then meet back together next week.
Okay.
All right. Sounds good.
This is just the beginning. Keep rolling.
Getting ready to
start my day.
Owen, you didn't just wake up. Be serious.
Neither has anyone else who says it on TikTok.
Well, we need to figure out what we're actually doing.
For real.
How about you look so dumb right now video?
That's not very Christian-like.
It was a joke, although not much on TikTok is very Christian.
Sounds like a good challenge for us.
Mm-hmm. I sense a fight going on.
We weren't fighting, Naomi. We were having a friendly discussion.
Yeah.
Okay, I've got it. We can do a series of Fortnite dances with scripture. It's TikTok, but with a twist. No pun intended.
What about Naomi's original idea? The animals?
But which animals? Even though Benedict 16 admitted there were no animals mentioned in the nativity scene. So, if there were, which animals? Llamas or even penguins?
Maybe giraffes. At least they live in Africa.
Africa?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It could be animals from historically inaccurate nativities. Because everyone promised not to tell Sally. Mm-hmm.
But I like my Fortnite dances.
Maybe there's a way to combine both ideas?
But, come on, can a llama floss?
How about we start out with Fortnite dances, and then after everyone arrives, we switch to the animal's point of view?
Yeah, that could work.
I just woke up this way.
It's so crazy, it might just work.
Looks like the whole team's here. I have an idea to get us started, so let's see where we go. I was thinking we would start with a question post. Those tend to get more responses when starting something like this. What do you think?
What would the question be?
I was thinking something like, what are the biggest issues facing our society today? Or something like that.
I think that's a great start. And maybe we can follow it up with some examples relating to people's responses.
That might work, but it might also be risky depending on people's responses.
Or difficult to depict.
Those are both valid points. What if we put together a photo montage depicting the issues, or depicting issues facing people who, or depicting issues commonly associated with people who need Jesus?
So like everybody's issues?
Well, pretty much. And then our third post could be the solution.
Good news of Jesus.
Yep. Any issues?
Wait, does anybody know anything about graphic design?
Oh, I know. Whenever we need something to go in the newsletter for church, we just send the information to Darlene. She puts it into a graphic design portal and designs a graphic, and then she posts it on Facebook or puts it in the website or in the newsletter or wherever it needs to go. I bet she can do it for us.
Well, it's not a bad idea. We can try that route. Thanks for the suggestion.
And this is how it starts, folks. It's calm now. But just wait and watch. Something interesting is bound to happen.
Are you guys filming our meetings?
And we are now interacting with the subjects themselves.
Why, yes, we are filming.
We want to make sure we catch every interesting thing that happens. It's real life with a real camera, here with Church Kids Live.
Yay!
All right, guys, move on now. Yep, go. Nope, it's our time for the stage. You can leave. But no, I don't want the mic in my face. You can just go without that. Yep. All the way. Bye. Yeah. Bye.
Turn and walk.
Doesn't it seem kind of sus letting them film all of our confidential information?
It sure does.
It also seems kind of like cheating to use other people's content for your own.
Kids these days, am I right?
Yeah, who's in charge of them anyways? I'm gonna text Pastor Tim to complain about this.
Well, how about our content? We need to get started. So let's start with...
You didn't say anything about singing and dancing.
Oh, it won't be anything too demanding. You'll be fine. Does anyone have any special talents, like backflips or aerial spins?
I can do jumping jacks.
I can do voices.
I can pick things up with my toes.
Logs.
Never mind. I'll figure it out.
So where are we going to do these flash mobs anyways?
I have this friend who works at this cute coffee shop down the road, the Olive Tree Cafe. I think we can do them there, at least for starters.
The Olive Tree Cafe, their pies are the best.
Their coffee isn't bad either.
I hope people don't get the wrong idea. I've heard that flash mobs can be used as forms of protest these days, and that kind of has a negative connotation to it, don't you think?
You're not wrong, Ruby. However, just like any form of media, it is a tool. The tool isn't inherently bad, it's how you choose to use it. Just like Facebook, Instagram, even a newspaper, or the news on TV. They can all be used for good, bad, or occasionally just for news.
You're not wrong, but if you put too much value in what you see on like Facebook, Instagram, it's gonna affect you.
Exactly, which is why these will be short, fun, hopefully entertaining performances that will highlight the good news of Jesus. Not exactly flash mobs, more like a flash performance. More like how troubadours were in medieval times. Roaming performers.
I guess that sounds like fun.
Let's figure it out then. Lead the way.
Church online design portal account, or on Canvas, or something like that, whatever that is.
Well, it's a start. Wow, she did a great job. We can figure this out. Okay, who wants to figure this out?
Maybe we could try Darlene again?
You should call her. You haven't asked her yet.
Okay, here goes. And if you're a task force member calling to request more graphic design projects, I'm knee-deep in the monthly newsletter, so you need to figure it out yourself. God bless!
So, who wants to figure it out?
Well, I guess the three of us could figure it out together. Could you do the last graphic?
Where is she?
Was that Darlene? We're trying to get her help to do a graphic project for our newsletter.
Oh, really? Don't you think she has enough to do?
But she loves to do graphics. I know she would help us.
Why do you guys need her?
Yeah,
why do you?
But wait. Brooke, call her again. Listen to this.
Hi. You have reached the office at First Baptist Church. We are unable to answer your call right now. If you would like to leave a message, please do so after the beep. And if you're a task force member calling to request more graphic design projects, I'm knee-deep in the monthly newsletter, so you need to figure it out yourself. God bless.
Hi, Darlene. This is Jack. We were wondering if maybe you'd have some time to help us with a graphic for our newspaper. It's nothing too bad. Something that would help.
I think she got cut off.
This is all your fault. Y'all are always doing this stuff to bother us all the time. We can't get any help from her.
Yeah, it's true.
You don't sound like Jack.
Because this is Brooke. Jack was using my phone.
But I'm here too. Thanks for calling me back.
No problem. So, this is a little awkward, but I do have good news. I have enough time to fit in just one more graphic design this week. I guess you guys can figure out which one of you would like it. Just let me know. Talk to you later.
Thanks.
Bye.
Great, so she'll do our last graphic.
That's right.
She said she would do a graphic. She didn't say whose.
And she already knows what we need, so I'm sure ours will be less work. Besides, shouldn't you guys be taking photos instead of using graphics?
Well, photos used to be the main way to add images to newsprint. Nowadays, it's actually graphics that are frequently used. Sometimes they're even in conjunction with photos.
She said she would do a photo montage for our next graphics project. Maybe we could share the graphic.
What?
No.
How would that even work? What is your graphic montage supposed to be like anyway?
Well, it's a picture of Sears depicting people's response of society these days.
I don't know. Maybe that could work. Why don't we run with it and see where it leads?
Sounds great. Hey, Brooke. Why don't you contact Darlene and see if she'll join our group? And then maybe she'll just draw a graphic for us.
Okay.
So is all the sports done? Do y'all have all that ready to go yet?
Yep, Aaron and I have the sports articles ready.
Okay. Well, I have the rest of the articles, but I haven't gotten to editing yet. So let me get to that, and I guess when we meet all next week, then we'll be ready to go, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Sounds good.
This is so exciting!
I can help with layout.
We cannot dress medieval. I'm not wearing tights. That just doesn't work.
Well, we can't dress like normal people. No one will pay attention to us.
They sure will if we're singing and dancing.
Or they might purposefully ignore us.
Conversation over. I have the solution to this problem. A perfect happy medium between medieval garb and modern clothing. I'll bring our costumes to the dress rehearsal. Trust me, guys.
All right. Well, let's get things ready. We'll start with scripture. We want to use the good news passage to stick with our theme. Do not be afraid, I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger.
What translation is that?
Yeah, isn't it good tidings?
What are tidings?
You know, like the ocean.
Oh, wow, guys. That's the tide.
Right. Tidings are like an old way of saying news or information.
So like, good news?
Exactly.
Why are we questioning the translation?
Well, you have to make sure you have the correct translation.
Sure, but Pastor John said good news in his sermon, so I'm gonna say we can use a translation that says good news. Now, back to scripture.
Do not fear.
We are here. Let's make this clear.
Go tell your peers.
That doesn't rhyme.
What doesn't?
Peers. It doesn't rhyme. You could say peer, but not peers.
It's close enough, Ruby.
I guess. I just really wanted to write this in iambic pentameter.
Iambic penta what?
Why iambic pentameter?
Well, Ruby, that is a great idea. But I'm afraid we don't have time to write everything in iambic pentameter. I love Shakespeare just as much as the next person.
Do you really?
Yes. But we're doing pop-up songs, not poetry in the park.
I guess. Piers still doesn't rhyme, but I guess we can go with it. In this day and age, anything goes.
Maybe not anything, Theodore.
I'm just dancing.
I don't think flossing.
Well, technically, a dance move is defined as a bodily movement or a series of movements, either traditional or improvised. So, I think it might count as a dance move, as much as I hate to agree with Theodore.
Ha! Wait, does that mean jumping jacks count too?
Theodore!
Apparently, it all counts. Now, how about this? We'll divide up the scripture and we can come back with ideas for lyrics at our next meeting.
I guess that sounds good.
Good, great.
Let's go.
So then.
fine. It's a lot closer to work.
Sure, I don't mind. So what's the plan for our reels of random acts of kindness?
So I was thinking we could look for situations of showing God's kindness in the everyday.
Okay, it's reaching out to people in the community sort of thing?
Exactly.
Hey, I live in a great subdivision. I bet that we can find all sorts of people to help us with our content there.
Oh, that's a great idea.
Hey, we know these people.
Hey.
Oh, hi.
We didn't know that we're meeting here.
Yeah, come join us. We're just discussing our first reel.
Coincidence.
Hey, mind if we come?
All right, sure, guys. Come on in and have a seat.
Poor girl. Do you think she has anywhere to stay?
Well, I think our first video is about to happen.
Really?
Sure, we could totally purchase her meal.
Ooh. Ooh. Quick, someone grab a camera and record me.
Yes.
Hi there. How are you today?
Fine.
What would you like? It's my treat.
I'm fine. Think so.
Oh, no. I insist. Hi, I'll be getting her order. Go ahead. Order.
I'll just have a coffee and a day.
Coming right up, Belly.
Oh, do you come here often?
Yeah, pretty regularly. It's close to campus.
So, do you live nearby?
Yeah, I live in the dorms.
Oh, yeah, that's great. Great. That'll be $8. $8? That's criminal. But nothing can compare to the price Jesus paid for our sins, of course.
Thanks for the coffee.
Happy to help.
That was amazing.
Well, you know, we'll just have to edit the part out where she says she lives on campus and visits the cafe often. That way we can show that we care for everyone, even the homeless.
Yeah. It's a piece of cake.
Yeah, good idea. Got it.
Well, you didn't specify.
Never mind, never mind. We'll try this. So hop up there, and we need two in the back, and one in the front center, and then two off to the side. Well, that's not exactly right. Google for a little bit. Oh, well, okay, that'll just have to do. So what I want you to do is just stand there while Gwen says her lines, okay? Just stand there, all right?
All right, say, let's go to Bethlehem.
Let's go to Bethlehem.
Okay, friends, let's try this again. Stand to the microphone.
It looks like the tin my grandma keeps her medicine in.
Hey, guys. Whoa, look at all of this. You guys stumbled onto some really cool stuff here.
Say cheese. Say cheese. Say, Miss Harper, what is all this stuff?
Looks like old-fashioned camera equipment to me.
That's not an alien, that's a sheep. What about this?
Yeah, that looks like some really neat stuff, guys.
Scanning, scanning.
Whoa, let me see that.
What is it?
That's called a light meter.
What's a light meter do?
Well, a light meter measures the light in a room so that you know how to set your camera controls.
What about this? I think it's a TV dish.
No, it's a flash.
Hey, what if we use this stuff for our video? Think it could work?
We can try.
Cool.
Cool. Cool. Let's get it set up.
Quick, let's get it all set up.
It's not release day yet.
Oh, got a little ahead of myself.
Aaron, okay. Ready to go?
Sorry.
Better go.
Gotta go.
Better go. Better go. This week is gonna be, oh my gosh, I can't believe this. Just a really cliff to go. Oh, hi, Lori, Nick, Daniel, girls, guys, the whole group. Well, we're through with our meeting, so we'll see you later. Good luck.
Thank you.
All right, team, we're in the final stretch.
Yes, we are.
Really?
Well, we already have one of our reels done, thanks to Lori and Caroline and Miles' great editing skills.
So, any thoughts on a second reel?
Well, for our second reel, a creative idea by Robin. We will need a backdrop. Something like a swirling wind, like a tornado.
I can't think of anything. You might have to make one.
Starry Night!
What?
You remember that nativity contest last year? We had a backdrop of a starry night. It's swirling.
I'm not sure that's kind of a swirling thing that we want.
Do you want to make one?
No, let's see if we can find it in the storage.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Okay, this will serve as our cutting room.
Do we have a B-roll ready in case we need it?
Sure do.
Okay, let's start checking things.
Aspect ratio, frame rate. Do we want a crop factor set?
No, I'm not gonna start.
Sounds good.
What were our end rate, Bippy? Do we need to consider compression?
I'm more concerned about the color temperature and white balance. We want to have a unique look.
All that's good and everything, but we need to come with those close-ups, pans and tilts.
And don't forget about the storyboard.
We have a whole season of tension in the task force left of us.
What do I do?
Yeah, what do we do?
Hold on. I'm sure we can get this all sorted out. Let's have James take point. divvy up tasks, okay? James?
Right, no worries. We'll address all those things later. I'm sure the result will be unique, even if it doesn't exactly follow the original storyboard.
Okay. Great, let's get to work.
Here, guys, I brought your costumes.
Choir robes? Really?
It seemed like a happy medium to me.
Ugh.
Is anybody else this short? This seems a bit short.
Well, ugh. Theodore, we're not that tall.
All right, let's get to practicing. Isn't it such a coincidence that the praise band is practicing tonight? We have dance music built right into our rehearsal.
Oh, I forgot. I found the hurdy-gurdy.
The what?
The hurdy-gurdy. It's a medieval instrument. One of the groups used it in last year's nativity scenes.
And full offense, that's where it should stay.
Yeah. That thing sounds like a dying cat. I was there, I saw the whole thing.
Okay. Thank you, Lillian, for finding it. But I'm gonna make an executive decision on this one. No hurdy-gurdy. Fine.
Let's practice our dance already.
I spent 2 hours practicing last night.
Yeah, I think I have a new bruise on my shin from when I hit the table.
Oof.
All right. New choreo first. Everyone in position?
I'm not really in the mood to talk to people right now.
It will only take a few minutes, and you don't look like you're going anywhere.
Okay.
Hey, fans, it's me, James, with Church Kids Live. Today we're on the streets looking for people in the wild, and we found one here by one of our favorite coffee shops. We found, what's your name?
Ellie.
We found Ellie.
What did you order?
Just a coffee and pie.
I like coffee too, but my dad says it will stunt my growth. Do you think mermaids are real?
No.
What color is your hair, Lily? Is it dirty or brown?
Blonde, I guess.
What about fractions?
Or decimals?
Or what about when your dad tells you to do something, but you really don't want to do it?
What? Look, guys, I really need to get going.
Oh, well, how about a real question? Why do you hang out here?
Well, I go to the college nearby, and I like to watch the people living their normal, carefree lives. People who don't seem as screwed up as I feel.
Okay, Ellie, we're out here looking for ideas of what people think of when they think of good news. How about you?
What about me?
What do you think of when you think of good news?
Nothing, really. I don't think there's much that could be good news to me right now.
Oh, that sounds serious. Why's that?
Because I left home and came to college and everything just got all screwed up, okay? Then I ended up in prison. Does that sound like good news to you?
Well, no, that doesn't sound like very good news to me.
But maybe.
I've got to go. Excuse me.
Hey, there's Abigail. Hey, Abigail, what do you think of when you think of good news?
Why, Christmas, of course.
What about Christmas?
Well, the birth of Jesus, duh.
Now we're getting somewhere. Jesus was born to be a human, the ultimate sacrifice. God loves everyone, even Ellie. Ellie doesn't have to be so down because God still loves her, but she's gone now. We were too caught up in our video to tell her that God loves her no matter what.
We're still rolling.
Right. Jesus loves you, and Jesus loves Ellie, and Jesus loves you. James, out.
Well, I guess our project didn't go as planned.
That's okay. You guys still got some good footage, and I think you learned a really valuable lesson, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think we got too caught up in our video.
Right. Next time we see Ellie, we'll tell her that God loves her no matter what. Church Kids Live is on the mission.
Great.
Yay!
Sounds like a plan. For now, let's head back to the church and wait there for your parents to pick you up, okay?
Okay.
Okay, all right.
say so myself.
I can't wait to show my parents.
Aaron, don't you have some of your friends who may be able to help you deliver these somewhere for us?
Like newspaper delivery boys?
Yes.
You got it.
We really should get some of these to some other places that have helped us. Oh, absolutely. That is one of the best places. They've been so kind to us for helping us out, and they said that they would let us have some. So let's go there now.
All right. Sounds good. Are we all together? Everybody together? Ah, great. Well, let's head out to the cafe to deliver some newspapers, and while we're there, maybe we'll grab a slice of pie or a muffin in celebration.
We're ready.
Jack, do you know anything about that girl outside? She looks a little lost.
No, I think she hangs around here a lot.
You should be careful talking to strangers.
I know. I was just handing her my newspaper.
Well, please be careful and let us know who you are, who you're with, and where you're going.
Yes, ma'am.
Live with our first graphic today, the second tomorrow, and the third the day after that. Should work out great. Lydia, can you show us the final products?
Sure. Here's the first graphic. And this is our second graphic. And finally, our last graphic. What do you think? Any questions?
It's a bummer she couldn't make it to our meeting. She said something about meeting her sister in Florida.
Now that's where I'd like to be.
Well, let's get logged in and post our first graphic. Let's see. Brooke, did you get the password from Darlene?
Sure did. It's Jesus is watching over you, so be careful what you say. What?
Well, it is a little complicated.
She said that's the public password, whatever that meant.
Okay. Jesus is watching over you.
So be careful what you say.
It didn't work.
What do you mean it didn't work?
I don't know. I typed it incorrectly.
Maybe you should have done it right.
Oh, wait. There's an exclamation point at the end.
Oh, yeah. Nope.
Oh dear, what are we going to do?
I suppose we'll just have to ask Darlene for the password again.
No way.
Maybe Pastor Tim would know the password.
Here, I'll text him.
What did it say?
It says capital J, lowercase e s u s I s w @ lowercase c h I n g, and everything else is the same. Capital J, an exclamation point at the end.
We did it. First post is live, and we have the others ready to release over the next few days.
No way.
Will one of you two?
Nope.
Try what? Liam.
Liam, will you ask them?
What is it? You need to ask us.
I'll do it. We want to ask for your help. We want to do a giveaway so we can boost views. But we don't have anything to give away. We were wondering if you could help us or point us in a good direction.
Well, that sounds like fun. Any ideas?
How about some church swag? Ellen may have a few items left over from the latest music fundraiser, and maybe Tim has a shirt or two.
Hey, thank you a lot.
I wonder what other items we can get.
Maybe stickers. Thanks, we appreciate the help.
Anytime.
Oh, and what about one more thing?
What would that be?
How about a basket, you know, to put the prizes in so we can make a prize basket?
Do we have any baskets lying around from these fairy hunts?
I don't think so.
Maybe in storage or something?
Hey, Darlene has been reorganizing the kitchen. Maybe she found a basket in there that could be repurposed.
That might just work.
Thanks.
Thanks.
Oh, I almost forgot. Do you happen to have any tape?
Tape?
I do. Let me look.
Well, mostly. The projector seems to be too low. Is there something we can use to raise it?
What about some of the books we couldn't get rid of from the library?
That might work.
I can't wait to see our movie. We're superstars.
You sure are.
We're ready to roll, Tommy.
Thank you.
Guys, this girl came into my barn, and you'll never guess what happened.
Meow!
You want me to eat this?
I'm not eating that.
That don't look like no oats.
Message today. This message is for you. It is for all people.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby that wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger.
Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth. Peace to those and on whose favor bless. Let's go to Bethlehem.
You too can go and see what this is all about. Visit thfbc.org for more details.
It's 6 o'clock, so we'll go ahead and get started. First off, I wanted to say great job to everyone. We're really getting things done. The first Facebook post is live, and the rest are set to follow later this week.
And our group has already published and distributed our newspaper to various people and places in our community.
And our commercial has been on the local channel 2 times already. We are on our way to Hallmark.
We're going to release a series this week, and the Facebook group to help us with a giveaway to boost our video views.
Ooh, what a good idea! I love a good giveaway. We go live this week also, and we're totally hyped. Be sure to come check us out at the Olive Tree Cafe.
We're doing okay with our videos. They haven't gone viral, but who knows?
We're in final editing. We'll meet the deadline this week.
Okay, now that we've all given our updates, I'll turn things over to the pastor. He's here to help us look at our accomplishments.
Hello, everyone. It's good to see everyone so enthusiastic on the projects and to see so many people involved in these endeavors. Those are both positives. When we began looking into this, what were our main goals?
To get the good news of Jesus to those who need it?
Yeah, to reach the lost.
Yes, that's the idea, and we talked about how Jesus modeled that for us, right?
By feeding people. And now I'm hungry.
Or by showing love and compassion.
Right. And who have you shown love and compassion to? Or fed?
Well, everyone who views our social media or any of our media, we're sharing with them the good news.
Yeah. Now all they have to do is read all about it.
What about people who have actually interacted with?
Well, we've been a college student coffee and pie.
College guy? I saw Nick and Miles doing some final edits, and I thought you guys were feeding the homeless.
Well, that's how we wanted it to seem. She actually goes to campus. She lives on campus and goes there quite often. We just kind of edited that part out.
Doesn't that seem dishonest?
Well, that's kind of the trendy thing to do. People record themselves feeding the homeless all the time. But I guess when you put it that way, we shouldn't be deceitful. I'll talk to my group about a change of plans.
What is this person anyway? Or who is this person anyway?
Well, she's a student. She just hangs around the Olive Tree Cafe often.
Hey, that sounds like Ellie, the girl we interviewed, but we got too caught up in our video and forgot to tell her that God loves her no matter what.
We gave a girl a newspaper there, too. Maybe it was her.
All right, guys. I'm glad to see all the work that you have been putting into your projects, and I hope God works them all for good. However, I really want us out there in our community with those that are suffering, hungry, and lost, doing what we can to show those Christ love. Until Jesus returns, we are his hands and his feet, and we need to be using them for his purpose. Perhaps all these great projects and guys have done will open up some of those opportunities. Regardless, let's think more towards going, seeing, and doing.
You betcha.
Absolutely. Okay. Okay.
Make this clear.
Go tell your peers.
Because Jesus is here.
Will you please join us in song?
Joy to the world.
Sure, I guess so.
Harriet. What's your name?
Ellie.
I think I've seen you around here before. What's your story?
Story?
You know, why this cafe? Do you live close by? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to pry. My friends tell me I can be a bit nosy. So?
What?
Are you gonna answer my questions?
No. I guess so. I do live close by. I go to the college down the street. I like it here because I can usually watch people, feel a little more normal, but remain anonymous because people here don't know me. And I like their pie.
My friend Lillian was just saying the same thing. They have the best pies. Oh, I think they're almost done. Is it okay if they join us?
Sure, I guess. Doesn't look like there's any empty tables left.
Thanks. Here's your drink. Oh, thanks, Lillian.
Why were you talking to her?
With who?
Her?
Yeah, why not?
Well, she looks like she just came over, like, from the street.
Well, isn't that what we just did?
That's different. We came from church.
And what, that somehow makes us better than her?
Well, no.
Keep working on convincing yourself there. Besides, she's just a little withdrawn.
What are we talking about?
Julia doesn't think we should be sitting with Ellie.
She doesn't look as bad as a tax collector to me. Maybe she just needs some good news.
Tax collector? Good news?
From Pastor John's sermon. Remember how Pastor John said that the Israelites had declared the tax collectors as unredeemable, and that's why it was such good news when Jesus told Matthew to follow him? Matthew was a tax collector, unredeemable according to the Israelites.
Well, when you put it that way.
Yeah, she's just a person. It's not like we can always look this pretty.
Speak for yourself.
Can we go sit down now?
Yeah, let's go.
You're back, and without pie.
Yeah, no pie today. This is Lillian, Ruby, Julia, and Theodore.
Hi.
So, what's your story?
Really?
I already asked her that. She goes to the college close by. We have a mutual appreciation for the pies here.
Cool.
So, what are you studying?
Well, I'm supposed to be studying psychology, but I got into a bit of a trouble, and that trickled down to my studies somewhat. I'm afraid my motivation for school hasn't been what it should be. Well, my motivation for anything hasn't been what it should be.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Is there anything we can do to help with your situation?
Probably not. It's my own problem. I just have to get it sorted. Besides, no good person should want to associate with me. I'm beyond help.
Well, that's not true. I'm sorry that you're feeling down and that you might be in some kind of trouble. But we have good news.
We do?
Yes. I mean, the same good news that we have is also good news for you. Jesus came to earth, was born, and died for all of us after all.
Yeah, but I've really screwed up, and I think God is done with me at this point.
That's not true. Our pastor just taught us about how the Israelites were labeled the tax collectors of the day as unredeemable. They were considered the worst of the worst in society. They couldn't even make sacrifices to redeem themselves. But then Jesus came, and he made a tax collector one of his disciples. So, you see, no one is unredeemable in the eyes of God, even you. Does anyone want the rest of
it? Oh, I'll take it.
I can't finish it.
Thanks, guys. You've at least given me something to think about.
You're welcome. We should probably get going, but maybe we'll see you here again sometime.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe.
Dinner after church today to show the release of our final two media projects. is gonna love that.
I think it'd be nice too, just having this dinner so everybody can see what we're doing and how maybe that's spurred people on to the next great thing.
And who doesn't love a church meal? I mean, perfect combination. Good food, good fellowship.
Hey, does anybody know what the children's YouTube giveaway is gonna be?
Well, actually, I do know because they came to our group for some help. But I'm sworn to secrecy. My lips are sealed.
Lydia, you're no fun. Hey, they did happen to get a new car giveaway, did they?
Nothing like that. Everyone around here sure seems to think big.
Hi, Iris. Good to see you.
Hey, guys. Can you use more help?
Hey, we can. You grab that silverware and put it out in the baskets so they can pick it up.
Got it.
Hi. Welcome. We're just about to start dinner. You want to join us?
Well, I'm not sure. Maybe. Well, I'm not sure if I should be here.
Sure you should. Everyone can be here.
Jesus loves you, even though you've done something bad.
But we're kids, so we know about getting into trouble.
Well, this wasn't exactly the same kind of trouble, but you could be right.
If everyone could take their seats, we can get started.
We got most of the way through our process.
And realize, kind of, during the process that we were sidetracked, and taken in by the current trends.
As such, we created just a single reel with the idea that showing kindness to everyone helps us to be the hands and feet of Jesus.
I bring you good news, oh, how that you hold. Jesus born in a stable manger, a miracle of earth.
Welcome to the adventures of the Church Kids.
Okay, this will serve as our cutting room.
Do we have a B-roll ready in case we need it?
Okay, let's start checking things.
What were our in-right fit? Do we need to consider compression?
We want to have a unique look.
All that's good and everything, but we need to film in the close-ups, pans and tilts.
Started right here, folks, the rebirth of newspaper. By the next year, everyone will be reading the newspaper again, and by the following, many will be new followers of Christ.
Are you guys filming our meetings?
And here we are interacting with the subjects themselves.
Why, yes, we are filming. We want to make sure we catch any and every interesting thing that happens. It's real life in the real camera, here with the Church Kids Live.
Yay!
Guys, it's time to go on now. Yep. No, you don't have it. Guys, just go.
I'm not really in the mood to talk to anyone right now.
Well, it'll only take a few minutes, and you don't seem like you're going anywhere.
Okay.
Fans, it's B. James with Church Kids Live. Today we're on the streets looking for people in the wild, and we found one here by one of our favorite coffee shops. We found a... What's your name?
Ellie.
We found an Ellie.
What did you order?
Just coffee and pie.
I like coffee too, but my dad says it's just not my grill.
Do you think mermaids are real?
No.
What color is your hair, Lily? Is it dirty or... brown.
Blonde, I guess. Or decimals.
Or what about when your dad tells you to do something, but you really don't want to do it?
What? Look, guys, I need to get going.
Oh, well, how about a real question? Why do you hang out here?
Well, I go to the college nearby, and I like to watch the people living their normal, carefree lives. People who don't seem as screwed up as I feel.
Okay, Ellie. We're out here... looking for what people think of when they think about good news. How about you?
What about me?
What do you think of when you think of good news?
Nothing really. I don't think there's much that could be good news to me right now.
Oh, that sounds serious. Why is that?
Because I left home and I came to college and everything just got all screwed up, okay? Then I ended up in prison. Does that sound like good news to you?
Too caught up in our video to tell her that Jesus loves her no matter what.
We're still rolling.
Right, Jesus loves you, and Jesus loves Ellie, and Jesus loves you, James Al.
The church kids live. Welcome to you.
lot through this process. Ellie, you may not know it yet, but God's not through with you. In fact, he's still using you today.
He may have brought you here today, and for that we are so grateful. And through you, we have seen what we need to be.
Yeah, we've seen that we can make more of a difference if we're out doing.
Even if the difference might be small, and it might be one person at a time.
And we may never know.
It's not like it's a Super Bowl commercial.
No, it's not. And you know, not millions of people will see it.
But we don't need people to see, as long as we're doing our part.
Coming alongside each other.
Discipling them.
Showing Jesus' love to the world.
And raising a new generation to do the same.
And sometimes, I think the new generation see things better than we do.
Me too. And I'm so thankful for that.
for coming tonight. We hope you enjoyed it. That is the end of our program. Thank you for coming.